we managed to get more than half the residents off the road for the third time in 15 months, signing a petition against it. I spoke to you in December about this, so please forgive me if I repeat myself, and also those who were at the site will have recognised many of the things I wish to say. BERYL Road was developed in the round about the 1920s, imposing 4 and 5 bedroom homes. And the general boundary treatment was brick pillars with low walls in between. You'll notice the first photograph, A, shows the wall as it was. Photograph B shows the new wall. So photographs A and B show the before and after. The wall under consideration is completely out of character with the road. All the other houses in Beryl Road, I'm not talking about West Road where there are tall walls, a quite different situation, round the wall. Beryl Road has walls which are low and are broken up by pillars. Some of the pillars, as I suggested, are of a similar height. They are only pillars, they are not a wall, as quoted in the department's application. The pillars are separated then by wrought iron, fencing, and greenery. This wall has no greenery whatsoever. This is a leafy suburban road, an attractive leafy verdant road, and there is no greenery there. Now, at your last meeting, you rejected it on the grounds that the appearance, scale, and sighting of the wall dominates the street scene and has a harmful impact on the character and appearance of the road. The next application included rendered panels, which your department said then and has said again, give an optical illusion that it breaks up the mass of the wall. We do not agree that this breaks up the mass of the wall. This was rejected by your committee in turn. The current application differs only in a very partial, very limited way from the one which was rejected, in that it proposes to lower it by one brick one-third of the way along and two bricks two-thirds of the way along. If you would like to have a look at photograph two, you will see the brick wall. Photograph B, sorry, you will see the brick wall. Photograph C, you can see one of the brick pillars, but you will notice that between the brick pillars there's a low wall or a fence or wrought iron work. And photograph B is similar. Those on the site will have seen all this themselves, so I'm sure you'll have seen it. I would like you though to look at E and F. E and F were put into the planning documents. E shows as it is now. Please do not look at the bottom pictures. They show the inside. The inside doesn't affect us at all. It's only the outside, the top pictures, that affect us. We were shown the inside at the site visit. The inside is quite attractive. It has pillars and it doesn't look so unattractive. The outside will not look like the inside. There are no pillars. I'd also point out that there are several factual inaccuracies in the heights. The department has said that the maximum height is at the gate and not at the other end. This is actually on the inside, not on the outside. If you look at the F on the outside, the top F, the top diagram on F, you will see that the right-hand end is said to be 1.9 metres high, but you will notice the bricks above it actually take it back up to the 2.2 metres. We therefore maintain that this actually has very little difference from the previous application, which was rejected. We do not believe that these clusters are going to make any difference to the site of the wall. In fact, they may even make a little more on the site. There are no pillars visible on the outside as there are on the inside. So we would therefore request that, as you have seen, this wall dominates the street scene and has a harmful impact on the character and appearance of the area.
Thank you very much. Thank you for keeping me in the time. Would the applicants all right to want to speak on this? Can you see me on one there? You can just say your name and address and you don't have to 5 minutes to
speak. Thank you, Chair. Thank you, Committee. I'm here to represent the actual landowner, the person who lives in the house, Mr. and Mrs. Parry. As the objectors highlighted, this is the third occasion that they've got to seek permission for their boundary wall.
Sorry,
trying to seek a consent for a boundary wall they've built without a planning approval. They appointed us to really look at what we could do to sort of maybe mitigate some of the sort of concerns of the neighbours. And what we've done is we've done a study of the boundaries. The neighbour has already highlighted predominantly the road built in the early 1920s, but you can appreciate there's been lots of changes since the 1920s. It's a road I use quite regularly myself, I'm very familiar with it. I understand the before and afters, they also understand the reasons why Mr. and Mrs. Parrott want to build a boundary wall on the boundary. In terms of our aid, in terms of design, I think it was quite clear when we did the site visit that the aid is to break the mass of the building, the wall, with materials that are quite familiar with the area. So the idea of a rendered panel within a brickwork facade, it's there to sort of illustrate that that's something you see quite regularly. In that area, and again, we've shown that in a study. In terms of the photographs that obviously Mrs. Gould just referred to, I've obviously not prepared to have seen them, so I can't really comment. What I can comment on is the drawings that we produced as a company. We've got set dimensions vertically, and we've got an existing scenario, and I've got a proposed scenario, unless you're all familiar with the planning consent, the word plan for you today, is as per the group drawings that are listed in the application. So thank you for your time. If there's any questions.
We don't do questions and answers. We'll tell you, we'll take on your floor, your comments, and then we'll debate it. Thank you. Okay, I'll open this. Sorry. Is there a ward councillor here to speak on this? Okay, can I open it up to committee? Any comments? Observations?
If I want to be popular, I wouldn't have come on the planning committee. Is another phrase. But we had an application last time. To be consistent, I found that a decent effort had been made to break up this blank brick fascia that was on the wall. And I think this has gone even a stage further. There's a slight decrease as the wall moves along in one direction. But I think what's happened and it often happens is if anything is built without pre-consent, automatically we are not happy with that. We're quite right to be indignant about the fact that someone built. I think what seems to have happened is a resident has seemed to make his house more private. So he's trying to protect his property. And the first attempt has been something a bit ham-fisted, to say the least. And that was an error, and obviously that is established there now. What we have in front of us now is an attempt to undo that harm that was done. My view is that this will make a difference, significant difference, to the appearance. And I know, again, the number of residents who protect that road with a vengeance, because it's a lovely road, and I know lots of people who live there and have enjoyed living there for many, many years. However, we are in the real world where people do seek different styles and want to protect them and want more, to be more secure and want more privacy. So people do that in various forms. They do it with fencing, they do it with large hedges, and in this particular case, they've done it with a brick fascia, which now is being attempted to be altered. So, on balance, I'm going to be consistent with where I felt last time, and this is even better application than the last one we had. So, and I know that's not the consideration of my other ward councils, by the way, who unfortunately couldn't attend tonight. I'm of a different opinion, but I'm not here as a ward councillor. I'm here as a member of the planning committee, and I think on balance, serious efforts have been made to break up the fascia of this wall to make it more acceptable. It's a judgment call on whether you believe it's acceptable enough to see planning approval. So my view is to see some improvement made, because what could possibly happen is we have a series of applications for the next 20 years and we're still talking about this wall in 20 years' time. So there's a genuine effort been made, I think, to alter it. And so therefore I'm going to grab the bed in my hand and probably support.
Any other comments? No?
consent to the relocation of the Reserve Forces and the Cadets Association building as a group with a new purpose building facility to be provided. The condition was imposed that required the new RSCA building to be constructed and available for use before any of the new homes approved could be occupied. Due to the site's previous use for employment and industrial purposes, substantial remediation and additional infrastructure works are required to facilitate the redevelopment of the site. Apart from the requirements for a licence for the new RSCA facilities, a remediated service access road is needed. Providing the RSCA with a new facility, together with other remediation and drainage requirements secured by condition across the site, has considerable and significant financial implications for the viability of the development of the new homes and the replacement of the RSCA building. Restricting occupation of any dwelling until the RSCA facility is built could significantly impact negatively on cash flow for the development and its completion. Therefore, in order to ensure sufficient return can be secured to enable the RSCA facility for specification can be built, it is proposed to allow a variation condition now to restrict occupation of the new homes to no more than 30% until the cadet facility is constructed and made available. The layout and all other aspects of the development remain as approved in December last year. Allowing the variation of condition, condition now will allow the construction of new homes, which will contribute towards the borough's housing supply, and also to ensure the funds are secured to provide the replacement RSCA facility that meets the association's licence requirements. The proposals are recommended for approval and there have been no objections to this application.
Thank you, Matthew. So we have no objections to this application. My understanding is that the cadets are accommodated in another building. Could you just confirm that for me?
The building is still there at the moment, but if at any time the building is removed, then there will be temporary facilities provided for.
Can I just move approval, Chair? So, let anybody else want to speak.
Thank you, James. Thank you, Eddie. All those in favour of approval of the amended variation? That's unanimous, thank you. Okay, so we've got agenda number 8 and 9 of those site visits. So if we go to agenda item 10, pages 53 to 92, please. This item seeks to gain members' approval for planning applications decided under delegated powers between the 7th of April and the 22nd of May. Are there any comments?
Page 66, Chair. Second one down, there's no more, this is a whole day for
you. Thank you. Stuart?
On the I'm not sure, Chair, if it's as part of this report, so it would normally come as a separate information item. Therefore, we receive information about appeals, dismissed, etc. I'm not sure whether that would normally appear in the agenda item 10 or a separate one. I understand that there was an appeal in the High Court. I'm not sure whether officers have intended to report the outcome of that. The appeal was to do with the Board of Appeals application, which I might be aware of.
General interest, and those were by the applause, it's the only applause I've ever from the applause, and we were party to the High Court action.
Yes, we have already reported on the appeal decision. It was when you went on
11?
3.
3, thank you. That's great, thank you. Just under any other urgent business, I'd just like to mention the training, which is on the 28th of June, at Committee Room 1, which will start at 5.15 and finish at 8.45. And I urge everybody who hasn't received any training to come. And